book haul here, and I thought I would show you some of the books that I've gotten over the last couple of weeks. And yes, I'm a bit of an addict, so this is going to be a pretty big haul. So the first thing that I want to show you is this trilogy here. It is Hades and Persephone. Depiction by Scarlett St. Clair, and it is a touch of darkness, a touch of malice, and a touch of ruin. This is quite different from something that I would normally read, but I'll read the back of this first one. Persephone is the goddess of spring in title. Since she was a little girl, flowers have only shriveled at her touch. After moving to New Athens, she hoped to lead an unassuming life disguised as a mortal journalist. All of that changes when she sits down in a forbidden nightclub to play a hand of cards with a hypnotic and mysterious stranger. Hades, the god of the dead, has built a gambling empire in the mortal world, and his favorite bets are rumored to be impossible. But nothing has ever intrigued him as much as the goddess offering him a bargain he can't resist. After her encounter with Hades, Persephone finds herself in a contract with the god of the dead, and his terms are impossible. Persephone must create life in the underworld or lose her freedom forever. The bet does more than expose Persephone's failure as a goddess, however, as she struggles to sow the seeds of her freedom. Love for the god of the dead grows, a love that is both captivating and forbidden. So, to be honest, what really attracted me to these books is the covers. It just seems kind of like a kind of dark fantasy type book, which I'm really drawn to these days. So the storyline itself sounds a little bit almost Twilight-y. You know, the whole forbidden romance thing is a big draw for a lot of people. For me, it's the fantastical elements of these fantasy books. I can take or leave the romance, but I'll give these a shot and see if I like them. I'm not a big fan of romanticizing a toxic relationship, which is what it sounds like is going to be going down in these books, but I don't know. Series, what I've done, let me know, but it's going to be quite a while before I get around to reading them. The next one I got, the next book I got is Hooked, a Never After novel by Emily McIntyre. This is a book based off of the story of Peter Pan. Says, once upon a time there was a little boy, his belly full of laughter, his life full of joy, until one day something changed, stripped his innocence away. The hole inside, making space for the devil to come and play. His dreams gone forever, he grew up way too fast. An endless night of crocodiles and watches made of glass. He grew into a villain, the taste of vengeance on his tongue, craving to make his enemies pay for the misdeeds they had done. Instead, he found a darling girl and refused to let her go. For what better way to make the man pay than to steal his little shadow? And that is Hooked. That one. next one is not a fantasy. It's actually a thriller, I think. It's called Verity by Colleen Hoover. And I've heard good things about this one. So we'll read the back. Loan Ashley is a struggling writer on the brink of financial ruin when she accepts the job offer of a lifetime. Jeremy Crawford, husband of best-selling author Verity Crawford, has hired Loan to complete the remaining books in a successful series his injured wife is unable to finish. Loan arrives at the Crawford home, ready to sort through years of Verity's notes and outlines, hoping to find enough material to get her started. What Loan doesn't expect to uncover in the chaotic office is the unfinished autobiography Verity never intended for anyone to read. Page after page of bone-chilling admissions, including Verity's recollection of the night her family was forever altered. Loan decides to keep the manuscript hidden from Jeremy, knowing its contents could devastate the already grieving father. But as Loan's feelings for Jeremy begin to intensify, she recognizes all the ways she could benefit if he were to read his wife's words. After all, no matter how devoted Jeremy is to his injured wife, a truth this horrifying could make it impossible for him to continue loving her. A standalone romantic thriller from number one New York Times best-selling author Colleen Hoover. Whispering House by Elizabeth Brooks. Let's read the back. Freya Lyle is struggling to move on from her sister Stella's death 5 years ago. Visiting the bewitching Burn Hall only a few miles from the scene of the tragedy, she discovers a portrait of Stella, a portrait she had no idea existed, in a house Stella never set foot in, or so she thought. Driven to find out more about her sister's secrets, Freya is drawn into the world of Burn Hall and its owners, charismatic artist Corey and his sinister, watchful mother. But as Freya lingers in this mysterious, centuries-old house, her relationship with Corey crosses the line into obsession and the darkness behind the locked doors of the estate threatens to spill out. In prose as lush and atmospheric as Burn Hall itself, Elizabeth Brooks weaves a simmering, repulsive tale of art, sisterhood, and all-consuming love. The ways it can lead us toward tenderness, nostalgia, and longing, as well as shocking acts of violence. So, this seems kind of a spooky book, a gothic mystery. This is the last of the novels, The Grim Rose Girls by Laura Pohl. I think that's how you say it. P-O-H-L. After the mysterious death of their best friend, Ella, Yuki and Rory are the talk of their elite school, Grimrose Academy. The police ruled Ariane's death as a suicide, but the trio is determined to find out what really happened. When Nani SS arrives as their newest roommate, it sets into motion a series of events that no one could have predicted. As the girls retrace their friend's final days, they discover a dark secret about Grimrose. Ariane wasn't the first dead girl. They soon learn that all the past murders are connected to ancient fairy tale curses, and that their own fates are tied to the stories, dooming the girls to can break the cycle for good. This is, I'm excited about this one too. So, okay, the last two books that I wanted to show you are not novels. This one is a magazine, The World's Most Haunted Places, Creepy, Ghostly, and Notorious Spots. So, anyway, this is a cool, kind of spooky magazine with lots of neat images. If you want me to go through this more slowly and read some excerpts from it, just let me know. But, yeah, I'm excited to kind of leaf through that. And I also got this one, Haunted Places. And, same thing. Interested in seeing anything from this book, let me know. I'll go through the first few pages. This is the introduction. I'll read this page here. Do ghosts exist? Are hauntings real? Can the spirits of the dead interact with the living? If you are seeking a definitive answer to any of these questions, then this is not the book for you. However, if you wish to conduct your own investigation, then within this volume, you will find a catalog of locations from private homes to abandoned institutions where some believe paranormal activity to take place. Why not visit and come on your own decision? For readers of a less active disposition, this book brings you images and stories from around the world of apparent hauntings and supernatural events. Some of the stories related here are horrific and barbarous in nature, including actions that would be regarded as crimes worthy of the highest sanction. Yet they were condoned or even encouraged by official bodies at the time. Other events are tragic accidents with no blame attached to the living or the dead. Whether you are a believer or not, read on and discover a world of unexplained occurrences and strange tales. But it's really, it's got some really nice images in it. So that was the main thing that attracted me to this one. Again, if you'd like me to do a flip through of this, just let me know. Okay, guys, that's it for the book haul. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you hit the like and subscribe button.